So yeah, Illumination Sing. And even though I enjoyed the first Secret Life of Pets and I liked the Despicable Me movies, in my opinion, Sing is one of the most enjoyable Illumination movies that I've seen. Now, is it the best movie they ever made? No, I still consider it a good movie. So, if you don't know the story, I'll give you the summary. Matthew McConaughey plays a koala named Buster Moon who is going to lose his theater because he couldn't pay the money he owned and his shows pretty much suck. The only logical solution is to host a singing competition. But during pre-production, an accident occurred that made everyone believe that they're competing for $100,000. As long as he doesn't let anyone know it was all just a mistake, the show can go on. After the auditions, he selected a couple of performers to qualify for the next round, including a stay-at-home mother, played by Reese Witherspoon, a teenage rock girl, played by Scarlett Johansson, a Frank Sinatra caricature, played by Seth MacFarlane, a gorilla who is the son of a gangster in the crime family business, played by Taron Egerton, and a shy elephant, played by Tori Kelly. So why do I consider it a good movie? Well, the funny thing is, the most entertaining part about this movie is the jukebox musical numbers. Yeah, they're obviously meant to make a soundtrack out of them with some familiar songs like Fireworks, I'm Still Standing, I Did It My Way, and so on and so forth. But the way that the movie works, they actually incorporate these songs pretty well. One of the problems that Strange Magic or Trolls had some pretty bad jukebox musical numbers is because they can be considered annoying and give out a solid vibe. They always hammer in the notion of what these movies are about, like Strange Magic is all about love, so all these pop songs have to be all about love. Or Trolls is a movie where everyone is happy and full of smiles, so we had to put in some song that's all about happiness and feelings. Sometimes playing those specific things can work in an actual musical, as long as the tone is different from any other songs. But since those movies are full of songs with nothing but love and happiness, they all feel like the same song over and over. I'm not saying a jukebox musical movie is a bad idea. Some of them can actually work, like with Happy Feet, since it's a movie about a dancing penguin who can't sing, but the other's penguins can. In the right hand, it does work as long as it brings us something new and unique. With Trolls and Strange Magic, though, it does not. With Sing, however, they handle the songs very well. They don't feel like the same music genre or tone. Considering it's a movie that consists of 65 songs, including an original song by Stevie Wonder called Faith, some of these songs do have a different music genre, like jazz, pop song, and so on. And the best part about those songs is that some of these songs actually fit the character. This is more evident with the final act of the movie, where we finally see all the performers sing a number. Each of them are pretty hummable and memorable. Shake It Off is a good opening. Don't Worry About a Thing is a great finale to the movie. I Did It My Way is fun and comical. My favorite song in the movie is actually I'm Still Standing, just how catchy and upbeat is. Now, do all the songs work in this movie? No, there are still some pretty bad songs, even if they are snippets of it. There are some songs, specifically in the audition scene, where some of the songs were pretty outdated, and you can see why they never made it to the actual round. But it's not just the songs I like, I actually like the characters in the movie. Oh, not the Matthew McConaughey character, we'll get to him later. I'm talking about the performers, because since it's a movie about a singing competition, all these performers connect to this one main story because they want to sing in this competition so they can fulfill their dreams. You got Rosita that wants to prove to her family that she's more than just a stay-at-home mom. Johnny wants to do a career in singing but wants to earn the love of his father, even though his father is pretty much a wanted criminal. Ash has to deal with her breakup, and Mina has to overcome her shyness. Speaking of which, Mina is actually the most three-dimensional contender in this movie. Not only because she wants to participate in this singing competition, but she also plays the role in the movie as the stage manager, and she adapts pretty well with it. The only performer that doesn't seem to have a goal to achieve is Seth MacFarlane as Mike. But the funny thing is, he is uncontrollably likable. He can be arrogant, but he has this Frank Sinatra Daffy Duck personality to him that makes him likable, and he actually goes all out like he thinks he actually won the entire singing competition. He joins a club, buys a car, and gets a new girlfriend. Now that I talked about the performers that participate in this singing competition, what did I think of Matthew McConaughey as Buster Moon? Well, even though it's a movie that's about saving this theater, Buster Moon is the least interesting character in the movie. We do get a backstory about why he wants to save the theater because it was owned by his father and he cares about it so much, but that's all we know about him. He only cares about his theater, and he can be stubborn when he focuses on the theater than the performers. For example, during the rehearsal, he wanted Ash to sing Call Me Maybe, but she doesn't like that song because it doesn't fit her. But Buster thinks it fits her because she's a girl. Get it? Get it? In other words, he just picks a song as he go and not let Ash sing whatever she wants until the very end. And as much as I like the side plot about the performers fulfilling their goals, the main plot of the movie is not really that interesting since it's about saving the theater. We've seen this kind of scenario before in other movies where it's about saving this one building, like with Blues Brothers, for instance. And also, the main plot can have some cliches, especially with the liar reveal story. Also, for the others, I kind of forgot Eddie was a character, and I thought the iguana character was kind of likable. The animation is decent, but it's not the best I've seen, but there are still some good elements. Some of the anthropomorphic animals are actually well designed, and the character animation is top notch, especially during the choreography during the musical numbers. The only thing that stands out in the animation are actually the visuals, like with the squid and some of the special effects during on stage. However, one of the problems, especially whenever people see this movie, it kind of looks like Zootopia, which coincidentally, Zootopia and Sing actually were released on the exact same year. One of the reasons why Zootopia is breathtaking is that Zootopia has these grand landscapes like a jungle, a desert, an island, and so much more. With Sing, the town they live in is just a regular town. The only advantage that it has over Zootopia is that it actually introduces us to other anthropomorphic species other than mammals, such as reptiles and amphibians and fish. Now, there has been some anthropomorphic animal projects way before Zootopia and Sing, like with Disney's Robin Hood. But for Illumination Sing, it's good, but it's not up there with Disney. But overall, I ended up enjoying this movie. I like the characters, I enjoy the jukebox musical numbers, and I thought the animation was pretty good. If you enjoy jukebox musical movies like with Happy Feet, then you'll have a good time with this. Now, since I liked the first movie, do I see some potential in the upcoming sequel to Sing? Honestly, no, actually, because the first movie had only one goal in common: raise money to save a theater and have the other performers fulfill their dreams. With the sequel, there is nothing for us after that happily ever after. The only potential I can see in this upcoming sequel to Sing is if the performers from the first movie compete in this worldwide championship singing tournament. That's it. Then again, we haven't received any updates yet on this upcoming sequel to Sing, so we'll just have to wait and see. But in the meantime, I have only one thing to say to Illumination. Surprise me.